We are now just a little under 3 months away from the official release of Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio, as well as creator George Lucas. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you are new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, what's really exciting about Episode 9 is that we do know that this film, at the end of the day, is of course going to have many different connections to the prequels, the originals, and even borrowing elements from Star Wars Legends, which may be a good or a bad thing depending on how it's all going to be utilized in this movie by JJ and how it's going to evolve the characters of Rey and Kylo Ren from start to finish of the plot of this movie. Now, on top of all of this, we do know that this film is going to be very important to Disney and Lucasfilm, but not just to them, but also to us, the Star Wars community, since it will determine the future of the Star Wars franchise. Now, apart from all of this, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very exciting for Rey and Kylo Ren. Now, specifically, what's really intriguing about all of this is that shot descriptions consisting of a sequence based toward the third act of the film, where it's described that both Rey and Kylo Ren are said to be fighting on top of the second Death Star wreckage, where it's explained that both Rey and Kylo are locking their blades together, where as this happens, it's said that the Force Ghost voice of Luke Skywalker is said to be guiding Rey during their scene, where it's explained that eventually Kylo Ren is said to hear the whispers of the dark side reaching out to him that are guiding him through the dark side to gain the upper hand against Rey. It's explained that these dark side whispers are said to be of the Sith Wraith of Darth Vader slash Anakin Skywalker tapping into Kylo Ren's mind, and that the whispers heard in the second teaser, just before Dark Rey's appearance, are said to be the whispers of Vader slash Anakin Sith Wraith. Now, it's said that Kylo Ren is hearing these whispers of ancient code being provided by the Sith Wraith of Vader slash Anakin, which allows him the focus to make powerful strikes against Rey that causes her to fall down and roll down the wreckage, where she is now said to be hanging over the edge of the second Death Star wreckage, with Kylo Ren standing above her trying to turn her to the dark side as she refuses. So let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, we do know that this film is going to have a lot of nostalgia, and it's going to have a lot of new different mediums that will be added to the franchise. You know, I think that the return of the second Death Star in the form of wreckage even is yet another piece of nostalgia that's being thrown into this movie, but it's actually said to be the very point in which both Rey and Kylo Ren have an epic final battle in The Rise of Skywalker, and is said to be the battle before they both go up against Palpatine's. So that's two lightsabers right there. We have a total of 4 lightsabers so far that are going to appear in The Rise of Skywalker. So we have one on the desert world of Pisana, we have one on Kijimi, we have one on the second Death Star, and of course one within Palpatine's throne room, and of course everything else in between. So there may be more than 4 saber duels for all we know, but so far there are 4 of them, and this particular scenario, it's said that Kylo Ren actually hears the whispers of the Sith Wraith of Darth Vader slash Anakin Skywalker reaching out to him. Now, this Sith Wraith is actually said to have been initiated by the Dark Acolytes of the Beyond, as we went over a couple of months ago. You guys may recall that J.J. Abrams originally had this idea for The Force Awakens of essentially a dark side spirit of Darth Vader slash Anakin that would be able to reach out to Kylo Ren. That's exactly what is happening here, and that's exactly what we hear in the second teaser trailer just before Dark Rey appears. You even hear whispers in the background and a word that says destroy. So it's very interesting stuff, I must add, and the fact that JJ is trying to do something so dark with this movie, and how he's trying to make the darkest Star Wars film out of the entire Skywalker saga, is very ambitious of him. In order to do that, you really have to do something incredible that's really going to top Revenge of the Sith. Now, do I still believe that he's going to be able to make this the darkest film of the saga? I'm still not quite sure about that. I'm really not quite sure if you can top, you know, Anakin being burned alive, or the youngling scene, or, you know, him, you know, indirectly killing Padme Amidala on Mustafar, all those different things, you know, her dying in childbirth. It was a dark film. So I don't know if they could really top those moments that were actually done by George Lucas. We'll have to wait and see. So the last piece that I just want to go over here is that Rey is also said to be guided by, of course, Luke Skywalker's Force Ghost as she fights Kylo Ren. Now, in case you guys did not know, there is going to be a Han Solo vision sequence within the Death Star wreckage. Kylo Ren is said to fall inside of there at a certain point in time in their battle, where he actually witnesses the Han Solo vision that's initiated by, of course, Luke Skywalker's Force Ghost. So the fact that they're doing something like that really is very inspiring by JJ, of how he's really trying to connect this movie to The Force Awakens. I don't know about you, but this film seems more or less a sequel to that of The Force Awakens rather than The Last Jedi being a sequel to The Force Awakens itself. That's just how I feel, and that's just how I feel The Rise of Skywalker is. It feels more connected, if you will, to Episode 7. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.